Welcome back, children. I hope you all are safe at home. This is your Netra ma'am from Mangala Vidya Mandira.
Mathematics class for second standard. As I told earlier, in this class we will be learning shapes and special understanding.
Welcome back, children. In the previous class, we learnt about line, types of lines, rolling and sliding. In this class, we will learn about 2D and 3D shapes.
See this picture, children. What is this? Yes, this is a house. This is drawn using shapes. Triangle, square, rectangle and circle. Now you are thinking, what are these? Now we will learn that.
Shapes. A shape can be defined as the form of an object or its outline. Now we will learn the types of shapes. They are 2D shapes and 3D shapes. There are a number of shapes all around us. Plane shapes are those that can be drawn on the flat surface, such as paper. It has two measurements, length and breadth. So it also known as two-dimensional or 2D shape. The four basic shapes are square, rectangle, triangle, circle. Now we will learn about square. A square has four sides. Four vertices. All four sides of a square are equal. Let us see some examples of square-shaped objects. This chessboard looks like a square, and this clock also look like a square. There are so many things in your house which are in square shape. Find it out. Now we will learn about rectangle. Rectangle has four sides, four vertices. Opposite sides of a rectangle are equal. Now let us see some examples of rectangle. You will eat biscuits, no? The biscuit also will be in rectangular shape. You can see rectangle everywhere. The scale which we use to draw lines and the door. Observe that in all these objects, the opposite sides are equal. This is a triangle. A triangle has three sides and three vertices. These are some examples of triangle. See these chips. You will like chips, no? The chips will also look like a triangle. Ask your mother. She will hang clothes, no? Check in your house. Hangers will also be in triangular shape. The carrot, radish will also looks like a triangle. A circle is a shape bounded by a curved line. Observe these examples, children. Now we walk on the road. You will see traffic lights now. The lights in the traffic signal will also be in circular shape. See this plate. This is in which shape? Yes, it is in circular shape. The bottle cap which you put your bottle will also look like a circle. Color the picture as directed. See, children, this is an ox. It is drawn using square, rectangle, circle and triangle. Now we should color the squares in yellow color, rectangle in green color, circle in red color, triangle in black color. Now we should write the number of every shape. First, rectangles. There is only one rectangle, so we will write 1. Now we should count the number of squares. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 squares. So we should write 4. Next, we should count the number of triangles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
6, 7, 8, 9. 9 triangles. So we will write 9. Next we should count the number of circles. 1, 2. 2 circles. So we should write 2. Till now we learnt about plane figures, which can be drawn on a plane surface or a paper. Now we will learn about 3D shapes. Solid shapes have three measurements: length, breadth and height. So a solid shape is also known as three-dimensional or 3D shape. In this class we will learn about cube, cuboid, cone, cylinder, sphere. 3D shape has three main parts. They are face, edge, corner or vertex. The side of the particular shape is called the face. The line where two faces meet is called an edge. The point where three edges meet is called vertex. Now we will learn about the cube. A cube is a three-dimensional figure. In a cube, every face is a square. It has 6 faces, 12 edges, 8 vertices. See children, the arrow marks in this picture shows all the vertices of the cube. Let us see some examples of cube. You have played with Rubik's cube, no? It will also look like a cube. And the building blocks will also look like a cube. A cuboid is a three-dimensional figure. In a cuboid, every face is a rectangle. Cuboid has 6 faces, 12 edges, 8 vertices. See children, the arrow marks in this picture shows all the vertices of the cuboid. See children, you will watch TV, no? It will also look like a cuboid. And read books, no? It is also a cuboid. Now we will learn about cone. A cone is a three-dimensional figure. In a cone, one face is plane and other is curved. It has 2 faces, 1 edge, 1 vertex. See children, the arrow mark in this picture shows vertex of the cone. Edge of the cone. Observe these examples. Children, you will eat ice cream, no? It will also look like a cone. While celebrating birthday, you will wear birthday cap, no? It is an example for cone. Now we will learn about cylinder. A cylinder is a three-dimensional figure. In a cylinder, two faces are plane and one face is curved. And it has 2 edges, no vertex. See children, the arrow marks in this picture shows edges. Observe these pictures children. The shell and juice can also examples for cylinder. Children, we learned solid shapes, no? Now we will solve some problems related to it. Now we should match the objects which are in the left side to the shapes in the right which look like them. The objects which we have are Agarbatti packet, matchbox, birthday cap, earth and Rubik's cube. The shapes which we have are cube, cone, cuboid, cylinder and sphere. First, the Agarbatti packet. How does it look? Yes, it looks like a cylinder. So, we should match the Agarbatti packet with cylinder. Next, we have a matchbox. Which shape does it resemble? You have seen it, no? It resembles the shape of cuboid. So, we will match it with cuboid. Next, we have a birthday cap. You wear it, no? How does it look? It looks like a cone. So we will match it with cone. What is the next picture? It is the earth. How does it look? It looks like a spear. So we will match it with spear. Now we have a Rubik's cube. Have you played with it? You know how it looks? It looks like a cube. So we will match it with cube. Children, now we should mark right for the objects having corners and count the edges and corners and write them. Here we have some objects. If the object has corners, we should tick in the first box. If it does not have any corners, then we should write no in the first box. Next, we should write the number of edges and corners in the next boxes. Now we will solve sums. For example, the dice has corners. So they have ticked in the first box. Next, it has 12 edges. So they have written 12 in the second box. It has 8 corners. So they have written 8 in the third box. Now, we will solve the next 3 sums. First, we have a ball. Does it have any corners? No, it does not have any corners. So we will write no in first box. How many edges does it have? No, it does not have any edges. So we will write 0 in second box. It also does not have any corners. So we will write 0 in the third box. Next we have a rubber. How does it look? Yes, it looks like a cuboid. Does cuboid has any corners? Yes, it has corners. So we will tick in the first box. How many edges does a cuboid have? Yes, it has 12 edges. So we will write 12 in second box. And it has 8 corners. So we will write 8 in the third box. Which picture is this? This is a cucumber. Does it have any corners? No, it does not have any corners. So we will write no in the first box. Does it have any edges? No. No, it does not have any edges. So we will write 0 in the second box. It also does not have any corners. So we will write 0 in the third box. Do this homework, children. Take a few objects such as dice, matchbox, carrot, coin. Keep these objects on a paper and draw a line around the edge with a pencil. Name the object formed and write the sides and corners or vertices and write the examples as the things in your home. Thank you, children. All the best for next activity. Stay home, stay safe.